Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I hope you guys all had a wonderful holiday. Today is New Year's Eve, which means tomorrow is the first day of January. A brand spanking new year. We have no idea what is to come. 2020 plus 21 literally was a blend. I mean, people were asking me what I did, when I purchased this, when someone came to visit, whatever the case may be. And I literally probably said the wrong year. I mean, I'm not the only one on this, right? So literally brain farting and blending the years together is not my fault. All right, guys, today is the last day of the year. So I decided to film a video out here with the Christmas tree. This tree is probably going into the compost next week or next garbage days. So why waste it? Let's go ahead and film my best of beauties 2021 now. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, I literally do have a good amount of things here. So if you guys are new to this channel, I love to beauty blog. I post monthly favorites at the end of every month. In addition to that, I film demo and reviews, first impressions. I love to explore and venture on all beauty products, hair, nails, I mean even regular things around the house. So, if you guys like videos like these, consider subscribing. Let's just go ahead and jump into this video because we have lots to talk about. So the first product I have here is Kosas. This is currently my favorite face powder to use. I love this powder because it softly diffuses the complexion. It gives a slight glow, nothing too crazy, but the pigmentation level is pretty light. So it's to set but not to really build, but the finish of it is beautiful. Another thing is that this is a baked powder, so that's why you get that mineralized kind of like glowy but not super dewy look. The package is really nice. It's like a frosted type of packaging, plain and simple. You guys know I love hydration on the lips, especially if it contains oil, super hydration, hyaluronic acid, because my lip condition definitely needs this. This here is by Wander Beauty. It's called a Lip Retreat. I chose this color in Skinny Dip because I love how nude it is. On my lips, it's very natural, very hydrating. So it's like a lip treatment with some colors, which is so nice. The doe foot applicator is like a little triangle with a nice slant, so it hugs my lips perfectly. Okay, so before we continue on, I just want to put this out there. I see a little trend going on with the things that I have. So far, it looks like a majority of my products here are clean beauty. Now, if you guys haven't watched my most recent video, it's a demo and review on Mirab Beauty. It kind of explains it, but without further ado, let's jump into Mirab Beauty. So these guys here have been my favorite from this brand. I am super grateful that they reached out and sent me some products. However, I did purchase two out of these. So the first one here is going to be their lengthening mascara. I literally have it on my lower eyes and under these lashes. But I kid you not, guys, this bristle is so nice. It's a regular fibery bristle, but this really helps volumize and just lengthen my lashes so much. I have stick straight lashes and nothing really works. This one here, also the Milk Kush mascara, the Hourglass Cautious mascara, maybe a Dior one, but literally it's like a handful that actually works with my lashes. This formulation helps because it doesn't overly clump my lashes. It helps extend it. And I have to say, these need two coats because one coat does not cut it. This here is their blending brush. So soft. I mean, I use this to put on powder. I love how it's like a kabuki dense-ish kind of brush. It's very flexible, so you can build with it, but it's also soft enough to blend. The hairs are so nice. The package is to die for. So cute. Here are two other lip oils that I've been loving. This one here is a really natural color, pretty similar to what I have on. This color here, so pretty. You wouldn't think this has a lot of pigment, but it sure does. This one here is so pretty because it has like a mocha feel to it, very high shine, but you see the pigmentation. I also do love the package. It's nice and like chunky. It's very stubby. The doe foot applicators are also very nice. Again, very smooth on the lips and you definitely get a high shine. This here has been a complete lifesaver, especially nowadays where we need to wear our masks all the time. Which is a good thing, but the makeup and it comes off is another bad thing. This here is a complexion stick. This is such a versatile product. You can use this as a concealer, a foundation, a touching up throughout the day, maybe carving your brow bone. I mean, sky's our limits, right? This also is a cream stick, so it blends very easily like a hydrating liquid foundation would, but it dries to kind of a matte finish, so it sets itself. I don't know what more I can say, but this is such a beautiful finish product in general. I'm usually not a big fan of these creams or sticks because sometimes I feel like when I apply on a lot, especially here, which I have a lot of pores and I dislike, sometimes it really accentuates it. I mean, it's gonna be there. Unless if I'm packing in some primer to really fill in those holes, it's gonna show. However, wearing this with my pore situation that I dislike, it actually is so subtle and soft. This gives so much coverage. I'm so surprised that it does, but it's just so soft on the skin and a super long wear. Yes. Well, can I first off tell you guys, if you guys didn't know, Tower 28 is an Asian-owned brand. That is right, guys. I had no idea, actually. Actually, there's two products I have from them. These are the products that I have with Tower 28. Oh my God. I am wearing this right now, and I kid you not, when I went into the store to buy this, I literally thought it was a tinted moisturizer. It's a tinted sunscreen. Love this so much. It's such a perfect shade for me. Underneath my makeup, I did not even put any primer on. It is so good. I love this so much. I need to refill on this because it doesn't matter if there's sun or not, this stuff is definitely needed to protect your skin. It's like a little droplet applicator. The formulation is so hydrating, so glowy, very dewy. So beautiful. This is such an amazing product. Again, this is SPF 30 tinted sunscreen. This is called Sunny Days. So I purchased this as a set. It comes with two. You can wear this alone and add this as a topper or mix and match. I just have been into browns, mochas, terracottas, burnt oranges, a tad bit more than I should be. So when I saw this, I said, I need to get this because there's not many lip glosses out there that has a nice brown tint that actually has a lot of pigment. This is such a nice formulation. The applicator is really unique. This applicator reminds me of those lash technicians that does false lashes, obviously. They use it to clean around the eyes for any dirt or any like extra fibrous cottons, you know, so it doesn't get in their eye. But this applicator really reminds me of that. I don't know if you can tell, but if you look really, really close, it actually has like little glitters in this gloss. It's very subtle, it doesn't bother me, but I just have to put it out there. It's tiny, tiny little glitter chunks. Very, very little. You can't see it. This one here is the clear gel, and literally, it's clear. There's no little chunks in it. It's just the colored one. And fun fact, when I first purchased this, I was wondering why it has like a slight tint to it. It kind of reminds me of topping the clear over this colored one. So of course when I put this on, I was like thinking to myself about these two colors mixed together, which means this. I freaked out, thought maybe someone used it and put it back in the package, and I purchased it. Laura Mercer. I have to say, I was never really a big fan of this brand. Why? I just don't know. So I finally tried a few more products from her line, and I have to say, don't knock it till you try it. I don't know what it was. The brand, it just wasn't appealing to me. You know, the package was just kind of like regular. But anyways, fast forward, we're here, we tried this, we like it. This is the Pure Canvas Blurring Primer. Now, like blushes, I only wear it on special events. Unless if I'm trying out for the first time, I decided to try this because one, it was sent to me. It also is a water base, so I feel like there's no silicone in there or dimethicone that would clog my pores or make my skin feel all weird throughout the day. I mean, if you look at this, because the middle I did put the sunscreen, but on the side, you can definitely tell that it does blur out the skin. So weird and bizarre. But so far I have been using because I like Tatcha. I have to say, I bought this because it came in a gift pack that came with the dewy spray. So I've been using the dewy spray for years. Love that stuff. Makes my skin so hydrated, so glowy because I need that extra oil, right? So during this holiday, I ended up purchasing it because it's a mini one I can take when traveling, but it came with these guys here that I've never tried. And oh my gosh. Love this stuff so much. So let's talk about this first. This is the Liquid Silk Canvas. This is like a primer, but like a skincare, which is kind of like a primer-ish, but like for the skincare side, because it's gonna help with the skin. Anyways, whatever it is, beautiful stuff. This stuff is just as amazing as a Laura Mercer blurring primer. I mean, if you feel this and this, it's so silky, so smooth. I have been using this for the center of the face where I have a lot of pores, but for the most part, this has been really nice to hide all my pores. This is a serum stick. This stuff is like a serum, but easy to use and travel with. It's like a glue stick, to be honest, when you apply it on, but it's so smooth. It literally cuts my skincare routine in half because I don't have to use like a whole bunch of products. Just using this serum with like day makeup, so good. This doesn't give any shine, but I can feel the texture difference and hydration. This is a wind up stick, and I feel like I can go through this pretty quick, but you know, you don't need a lot of it. But for me, I'm like, oh my god, this feels so good. I purchased this pencil, I believe July of this year when we went to Vegas. Such a good pencil. This is One Size by Patrick Starr. The name of this is called Point Made. This glides so smooth. It's a waterproof pencil. I have it on my upper waterline. I actually went to go see a friend earlier to exchange gifts and I teared because, I mean, you know, I'm a happy person, I'm emotional, I'm a crier. So with that said, you know, I teared. My eyeshadow did kind of wear off on the corner, but my eye pencil stayed in place. YSL. No, LYS. Why love yourself? Honestly, I love this brand so much. I say this a lot, but no, seriously, that I bought majority of their line. And I have to say, their line is fairly new, so they probably only have like 10 SKUs, but whatevers. I bought like, you know, 8 out of the 10. So the favorite things that I like are these three here. I love them so much that I bought doubles and maybe even quadruples just as backup. A rose gold frosted glass bottle for their foundation. Everything is in a triangular shape. I don't know what came over me, but I just really, really love this brand so much. This one here is their Triple Fix Serum Foundation. Now this foundation, I'm gonna apply it to this side since I didn't do anything here. This here, oh my gosh, this foundation here gives the best finish ever. If anyone else can find something better, please comment down below. So this here is a water-based foundation. It has so much pigment. It has a beautiful glow. The finish of this is beautiful. I mean, I know I said this a million times, but I'm going to mention it one last time before the year ends. The main reasons why I love this foundation is because it gives such a glowy finish, and you can also build with this foundation. Many times products that are more dewy and glowier tend to be more sheer, so using this, it just totally beat every foundation. You got the glowiness, the hydration, you got the skincare, you got the coverage, and you got the long wear. Earlier this year, I was in the market for a new bronzer, didn't know where I can find one. Lorac is my favorite contouring type of bronzer. Second runner up, I would have to say, is Cover FX, and then Kat Von D's contour palette. And then I stumbled across this guy. Love this so much. This is a matte bronzer. Very pigmented. It has an extreme amount of long wear. It blends beautifully, and this is like a perfect shade for me. Setting and brightening powders, I don't really use that much unless if I find something that I like. I found this guy. This guy here is a brightening banana powder. I use this to set under my eyes. I can use this to even set my whole face from the foundation. It's so soft. It brightens. But it's not cakey, it's like so soft. I love this stuff so much. And best of all, these powders are all talc-free. Lilia B. This here is such a cute little package. It's like a stone, a rock. It's white, so beautiful. It's pretty heavy, but I just like the size of it, so cute, and it opens just like that. This here is a concealer and eye prime dual. It's one shade, but you can use it for both purposes. This, I would have to say, as you can see, it's very creamy. Set it with powder before applying on, you know, eyeshadow or foundation or any other products on the face because it does tend to crease up, but I do love this formulation a lot. It's so light, but it has a lot of hydration, especially for like around our eyes that needs the extra attention. This is just easy to travel with, especially if you don't want to carry a lot of liquids. This is like a 2-in-1. Oh my god, do I even have time for all this stuff? This is crazy. Okay, It Beauty. This is by Addison Rae, I believe. This concealer here, I've been loving. The package is cute. It looks like a pencil with an eraser. The Doe Foot applicator is like humongous. I would say it's like a more tapered version of the Tarte Shape Tape. This is a great formulation. Again, lots of pigment. This tends to settle and dry pretty quickly, so it's more of like a semi-matte finish. If your eyes are dry under the eyes or certain areas, I would recommend applying on more moisturizer or a hydrating primer under there. Otherwise, it's gonna settle a little bit into the fine lines or gives a more matte finish. This lip gloss, I've been loving. This is such a beautiful color. It's literally your lip color, but better. I would say this is a little bit more corally. It's really pretty. It has a really unique doe foot applicator. Kind of like a pointy teardrop, but you know, it has a nice little scoop to hug your lips. This literally gives you like a glass-like finish for your lips. So nice. And this smells so good. I'm not really into like lip plumpers, but let me tell you, using this thing on bare lips, woo! The tingle from the peppermints, the peppers, whoa. This really does plump up the lips. It's so nice. It's a clear gloss you can wear alone or as a topper. It's a regular Doe Foot applicator. I mean, I'll try it on right now. Ooh, it's so spicy already. Yeah, it's spicy. It is spicy. It's so good. Does it make my lips bigger? So this here is Rare Beauty. I have been in love with Selena Gomez ever since she was a baby. And when she came out with this makeup line, I want to say 2020, but it felt like it was just this year. So I have been in love with her foundation. This definitely is a full coverage. I'm also very happy that she offers a extremely wide range of shades for most complexions. This is like a weird little like applicator. Normally it's a pump form or like a screw off and you kind of like put it on your sponge or you know on a palette. This is like a weird doe foot applicator. It reminds me of like Lego blocks. Large doe foot applicator. This is great to spot treat and then you can use your tool of your choice to blend everything out. You see how this finishes? It's so silky, very serumy, easy to glide, blend, and move on the skin. And once it sets in the skin, it just becomes more of a semi-matte finish. Kind of disappointed because I need to get a new shade in this. Got some color, not much color in the summer, and I tried this in my last few videos. It's too late. Here is her lip gloss. I like the package. It's nice and flat so you can place on the table or stand it up. I usually like to choose these regular kind of like nude lip colors because it's easy to add to or wear alone. This has a similar formulation and pigmentation level as the Tower 28. The applicator has a very tapered and very narrow type of shape. I have a few more products. This one here is by Eve Lum. Ooh! If you guys haven't seen my most recent skincare video, I'll put the link somewhere on the screen and of course down below. This here is their moisture mask. Oh my gosh, to die for. This is a beautiful mask that gives you such a hydration, such a glowy finish. You can wear this to sleep and wake up with super soft skin, or you have the choice to leave it in the skin and wash it off. A little goes a long way with this guy, so you don't need a lot. I believe this is their Retreat line, so this really helps with, you know, anti-aging, prevention. It's gonna help with existing. Overall, on the skin, it feels so luxe and like so rich. It just feels so nice on the skin. So if you guys haven't tried it, try out Eve Lum. Things with CBD has been very popular, but I've only tried one thing, which is this guy here with that. This here is a serum I like to place in the refrigerator. So in the mornings, if I need to wear this or at night, it's just nice and cold to really relax my skin. This is called the Chill Out Serum, so regardless, it's still pretty cold in the bottle. It's just so much nicer when it comes from the refrigerator. It just feels so cool on the skin. I usually like to have this on and place a sheet mask on and just let it just soak into my skin. This brand was actually one of my favorite drugstore products, so check out Flower Beauty if you guys haven't. Did you guys know that Wishful, same boss lady Huda Beauty? I had no idea she created a skincare line. I've seen this brand all over Sephora. I just wasn't aware that it was created by Huda Beauty. This is their cleansing butter? Yeah, cleansing butter. Whoa. this stuff feels like literally butter on the skin. I'm a big fan of makeup melters, so anything from Pharmacy Beauty, IT Cosmetics, Clinique, now it's Wishful. This stuff breaks everything down like most makeup melters. This has a lot of skincare properties that will benefit your skin. It has green tea in this, so it helps with redness. There's cherry blossom to help brighten the skin. And the last thing they have is a malachite. I don't remember on the top of my head what it does, but I know it's good for your skin too. So while breaking down all the makeup to prep your skin for the next few cleanses, this is gonna be very helpful to your skin. It's the 3-in-1 mist. Love this so much. I use this before, in between, and after my makeup services. Even if I'm just skincare spa treatment at home, this is sprayed all over, and not only for the face. I usually like to spray it on my décolleté to give it a nice, beautiful glow. This has, I believe it's either papaya or is it guava? Either way, so hydrating on the face. Smells so good. This is perfect for an extra glow. All right guys, last but not least, it's going to be the Anastasia palette. This here is the Primrose palette. So beautiful. I am wearing the colors on my eyes right now. Let me tell you how happy I am that they have the color Saddle in a big pan, because again, this is like my color jam right here that I've been loving. Grapefruit has been a beautiful color as a wash all over the lids. Kid you not, I used this all over the lids first, warmed it up with a little bit of Saddle, then I jumped in with the more barrier colors and I added this rose water here to my lids. All of these are so pretty. There's high shine, matte, there's metallic. I mean, this is such a beautiful arrangement. And the selections of different finishes, superb. I have to say, all the palettes that I purchased with Anastasia never failed me. This is my most recent palette with them and I love this so much. This can be used for all seasons mixed with other palettes. It's such a beautiful, beautiful palette. And I know they didn't want to have like their standard brown and black in this palette because it's more primrose. It's really rosy and gold-like. Either way, this is such a good palette. You guys should check it out. I know that was such a long video. There were so many products. As always, I'll put everything down in the info box for you guys. Honestly, all the products that I shared with you in this video, I truly love. I've been using these products throughout the year. I'll continue using it until I find more goodies to share for the next year. I just want to say thank you to all the viewers out there who view my channel, who support it, and enjoy my videos. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys so much for watching my last video of 2021. I hope you guys have a blessed, safe, and healthy new year to come. We definitely need to show more love and support to one another. So as always, be kind to each other. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one.